I want to talk to you today about the differences between ceramic tile and porcelain tile. These terms can be confusing when you're shopping, and the big box stores and the tile stores often don't help matters by throwing around different marketing terms that generally are meaningless. It's not that difficult to understand the differences between porcelain and ceramic, so I'm going to try to help you do that today. Ceramic tile is a softer tile. And generally, it has a glazed surface like this. This is subway tile that you've all seen before. This one here is also ceramic, but it's sold as a Carrera. But it has a matte finish, but it's also a glazed surface. And underneath this glazed surface is a softer clay that's used, generally a white clay. So when you chip off the surface of this glaze, the tile underneath will show through. And if this happens, this is white, but if it happens to be a color, you know, it's generally a white clay underneath that's going to show through. So ceramic tile is less durable than porcelain tile. Porcelain tile, it may also have a glazed finish, but generally speaking, the color goes all the way through. Like you look at this tile right here, again, it's a matte finish, but the charcoal gray color goes all the way through. So if you manage to chip this, which would be more difficult because it's a harder tile, then the color is through body, so it shows through, rather than some white clay that's going to show through. Porcelain tiles also tend to be the ones that have a textured finish. Not that that can't happen in a ceramic tile, but generally speaking, it's the porcelain tiles. There is a hardness rating called a PEI rating, Porcelain Enamel Institute rating, which goes from 0 to 5. A porcelain tile is going to have a 4 or a 5 rating. A ceramic tile is generally a 0 to 3 rating. And so that helps show you, if you can find a PEI rating on the side of the box, that'll help tell you whether it's a porcelain or a ceramic tile. So generally speaking, I push people towards a porcelain tile because it's a denser clay. It is more durable. It absorbs water less readily than a ceramic tile. So it's going to hold up longer. So I push people towards porcelain if at all possible. Sometimes the look you're after, though, you need a ceramic tile. There's nothing wrong with that. I just want you to be aware of what you're getting, and it tends to be a less durable tile. When you're installing tile, a ceramic tile, you can get away with cutting dry sometimes. A porcelain tile, you're always going to need a wet saw with a diamond blade. So this is more difficult to install, but it also holds up better. So those are the key differences between ceramic and porcelain tile. Ceramic tile, you know, if you need that look and that's what you're after, don't worry about it. Go ahead and use it. But just be aware that it's less durable and you need to be careful about dropping things on it. A porcelain tile, if you're in a commercial application or a residential application that gets a lot of traffic, that's what you're going to want. This more durable material, it uses clays that fire harder and more dense so that it's going to hold up in the long term. But those are the key differences between porcelain and ceramic tile.